Well, it took 6 days, but a champion was finally crowned at the Bob Hope Classic.
Settle in as we rewind the week with the latest edition of Monday Backspin from PGAtour.com.
Like father, like son, Bill Haas has won the Bob Hope Classic 22 years after his dad, Jay.
Bill Haas is full of hope, winning his first PGA Tour event in his 137th start. Haas and father Jay become the fifth father-son duo to win the same tournament. Hi, everybody. I'm John Swantek. For more than 50 years, the PGA Tour's Bob Hope Classic has always been a special tournament, a chance to pay tribute to one of the game's true ambassadors for not only the tour's best players, but also musicians, actors, celebrities, and yes, even former presidents. Bob Hope was an American icon who was noted for his work with the U.S. Armed Forces and his numerous USO tours, entertaining and inspiring American military personnel all over the globe. Well, this year's Bob Hope Classic was equally entertaining, beginning early Wednesday morning when Hall of Famer and baseball legend Yogi Berra struck the ceremonial first tee shot. 40-year-old Shane Birch then proceeded to shoot his career low round, a 10-under-62, taking the first round lead. In the California desert, of all places, heavy rain rolled in Wednesday night and all of Thursday, about 2.5 inches, more than PGA West saw all of last year. The second round was washed away, the first time that has happened at the event in 30 years. A Monday finish was in play.
It's a mess. I've been coming out of here for a long time and I've never seen anything like this.
Once play resumed on Friday, the amateurs and celebrities had to watch from offstage as the PGA Tour players attacked the soft conditions and a course record was broken. Bubba Watson had us all thinking 59 after scorching the front nine on the Silver Rock course in 29 strokes. The big left-hander would have to, well, settle for a 10-under-62 and the course record. Finally, the weekend provided some beautiful weather. Amateurs and celebrities were brought back out on the links and, well, they're amateurs for a reason.
That's good.
But those wayward shots weren't the only mess-ups over the weekend, as rookie sensation Ricky Fowler, he may have been suffering from a little identity crisis. However, the Ams did deliver a few pro-style shots, and in the case of football great Sterling Sharp, a few parting shots as well.
If I'd have played golf first, I'd have never played football.
Wow.
I really enjoy being out here, and I mean, I'm going to work with the pros, and that's a lot of fun, but I probably would not have played football if I'd played golf first.
Bubba Watson fell one stroke short in pursuit of his first PGA Tour win, but still will have special memories from this tournament after surprising his wife Angie with a rather unusual anniversary gift.
I love the game of golf, and Bubba knows how much I love it, and he knows how competitive I am with the game, and he surprised me back September 1st, our 50th year anniversary, with a spot in the Pro-Am, just a gift of a lifetime.
Very smooth, Bubba. Nice move. Now, for more from sunny California and the equally smooth Bob Stevens from the PGA Tour Network on Sirius XM Radio.
It is hard to believe that this fantastic weather we have had to finish up the Bob Hope Classic was so awful early on in the week. And maybe that is all a credit, the fact that we have forgotten all that rain, to William Lopez and Tim Putnam and Robert Durkee, the course superintendents at the four courses that make up this complex here at PGA West and at La Quinta and at Silver Rock. They were the real heroes this week. Their names are not at the top of the leaderboard, but the superintendents and their staffs were the ones that really made this tournament able to finish. Golfers were raving about them all week long and the great job they did of getting the water out of the bunkers, getting the fairways clear, and making for such a fabulous finish. Now we go over those mountains to San Diego to Torrey Pines. Yeah, it's been raining over there as well, and it'll be a whole new set of challenges. We invite you to join us on the PGA Tour Network, Sirius XM Radio, and also on PGAtour.com for all the coverage. Live play-by-play begins Thursday at noon Eastern.
Okay, thank you, Bob. World number two Phil Mickelson makes his 2010 tour debut this week at the Farmers Insurance Open at Torrey Pines. Golf Channel has your early round television coverage beginning Thursday at 3 p.m. Eastern.